Hi dear students, good morning and welcome to my today's online class. I hope you all have been well and getting yourselves prepared for the upcoming SSC test examination according to the syllabus we gave you. In the last class, we did SSC questions under Dhaka Board 2019, and today we are going to do questions under Rajshahi Board 2019. Okay, no more delay. Let's start and first look at question number 4. I mean right forms of verbs. Question number 4. Complete the following text with right forms of verbs given below. And the given verbs are understand, respect, form, succeed, consider, acquire, owe, admit, take, forget. Okay. To have an idea, before we fill up the gaps with right forms of verbs, let me read out the text once. In an educational institution, teacher-student relationship is a gap to be the most important matter, full stop. It is such a relationship that is big gap on the basis of mutual see gap full stop. A student always dig gap to his teachers because he cannot but a gap help from them in case of F gap knowledge full stop. The sensible students never G gap their teachers full stop. Moreover, they H gap their memorable teacher's role, which helps them I gap in life full stop. So they always J-gap their teachers. So dear students, this is very much clear now to us all that the text is related to teacher-students relationship, and here those who are good students, grateful students, they become really grateful to their teachers because they get help from them. Okay, now let's try to complete the text. In an educational institution, teacher-student relationship is to be the most important matter. Here the verb is to be verb, verb to be. Relationship is then to be. That means the verb is going to be in past participle form. Okay, let's try to find out the appropriate verb here. Is to be. Consider, and we need to write considered. Is considered to be the most important matter. Considered. Considered to be the most important matter. It is such a relationship that is, again, the same structure, that is, on the basis of mutual, okay, that is formed, that is formed, let's write first, that is formed on the basis of mutual, now we need noun here, that is, we need the verb with ing, on the basis of mutual understanding. On the basis of mutual understanding, a student always to his teachers because he cannot but help, he gave help from them. Okay, in this sentence we have three gaps in one sentence. A student always this word, this verb, oh. we need to write O's as the subject is third person singular number. O's to his teachers because he cannot but. It's a sentence structure, cannot but take help, cannot but take help in the e-gap, take, cannot but take help from them in case of, every time we see, if there is of before the subject, then we need to turn the verb into noun, that is, with ing. Here, from them in case of knowledge, this one, acquiring knowledge, in case of acquiring knowledge. In case of acquiring knowledge, the sensible students never their teachers. Never forget their teachers. Never forget their teachers. Full stop. Moreover, they each gap their memorable teacher's role. They admit, each gap. They admit their memorable teacher's role, which helps them in life, which helps them succeed in life. Helps them succeed in life. So, they always, their teachers. So, they always, only this one is left, respect their teachers. Let's read out once with the verbs in the gaps. In an educational institution, teacher-student relationship is considered to be the most important matter. It is such a relationship that is formed on the basis of mutual understanding. A student always owes to his teachers because he cannot but take help from them in case of acquiring knowledge. The sensible students never forget their teachers. Moreover, they admit their memorable teacher's role, which helps them succeed in life. So they always respect their teachers. Okay, dear students, we have finished doing question number 4. Now look at question number 8. Complete the text adding suffixes, prefixes or both to the root words given in the parenthesis. This time also, let me read out once for you. Bangladesh is a gap river and bigap agriculture country. So we cannot ignore the sea gap, important of rivers. Our agriculture is largely the gap depend on the rivers, but we get EGAP sufficient water for use from the rivers. There are FGAP differ reasons behind it. Full stop. At first, the water of many rivers, GGAP, dry within bracket, up in summer. Again, the water of some rivers is H-gap, extreme within bracket, poisonous, full stop. The poisonous water is I-gap, within bracket, should for our agriculture. So, water pollution should be prevented at any cost for the J-gap, within bracket, better of our agriculture. Okay, so now let's try to fill up the gaps by adding suffixes or prefixes or both. Bangladesh is a river, agap river and bigap agriculture country. So Bangladesh is a like here, is, generally we get adjective. Bangladesh is a riverine, and as there is coordinating conjunction, so this word is also going to be adjective. Bangladesh is a riverine and agricultural country. Riverine and agricultural. Agricultural country. So we cannot ignore the sea gap, important of rivers. Again, one more thing to be noticed here, either before or after. If there is off, generally, then the word is found to be noun. So we need noun form of this word. This is important means adjective, and noun form is importance. Ignore the importance of rivers. Importance, sign of importance. Importance of rivers, there are F gap differ reasons. There are reasons. How the reasons are? Adjective. We need adjective. Different. There are different reasons. Different reasons behind it. At first, the water of many rivers very easily, there is no verb, so we need a verb. Many rivers, the water of many rivers, G gap, dry up in summer. We need verb here. So it seems that this verb is going to be plural, no, but we need to know here the subject is not plural, not rivers, the water, and that's why we need singular verb. Dries up. Sorry, O, A, B, C, D. Where is D? Sorry, there's a mistake. Importance, then our agriculture is largely, sorry,
D-gap, I have done a mistake,
D-gap, largely is largely, again is largely, we need adjective, dependent on the rivers, dependent, D-gap, dependent. Dependent on the rivers, but we get sufficient water for use from the rivers. But as here, but is used, so we need to know that the word in the parenthesis is going to be in negative form. We need to use negative of this word sufficient. So negative word is insufficient. Insufficient, but we get insufficient. Insufficient water for use from the rivers. There are within bracket differ reasons. Okay, the reasons, how are the reasons? Different, adjective, different. different reasons behind it. At first, the water of many rivers here, we have already discussed, dries up, G-gap, dries. Dries up in summer. Again, the water of some rivers is H-gap, extreme, poisonous. As I told you earlier, if we leave the word in the parenthesis, still the sentence is complete. Let's look. Again, the water of some rivers is poisonous. That means, if we don't use the word in the parenthesis, the sentence is complete. So, here, the word should be adverb, extreme, extremely, extremely. Extremely poisonous. The poisonous water is I gave should for our agriculture. That is, we need negative of this word. And first, we need to turn this word into adjective, as to be verb is here. The poisonous water is, the adjective form of this word is suitable, and negative is unsuitable. We need unsuitable. The poisonous water is unsuitable for our agriculture. So I get unsuitable. Unsuitable for our agriculture. So, water pollution should be prevented at any cost for the J-gap within bracket better of our agriculture. Again, I need to remind you that either after or before the given word, if we find of, generally the word is found to be noun. So noun form of better is betterment. Betterment, J-gap. So, dear students, today we have finished doing question number 4 and question number 8. And as usual, in our next class, we will do question number 7 and 10. So, till then, before I finish, again, I would say be engaged in studies and stay at home, stay safe. Before we meet again in our next class, I would say Bye.